Okay, this is a question from IFT previously. Let's see what this says. Ashish is studying late into the night and is hungry. He opens his mother's snack cupboard without switching lights, knowing that the mother has kept 10 packets of chips and biscuits in the cupboard. He pulls out 3 packets from the cupboard. All of them turn out to be chips. What is the probability that the cupboard contains 1 packet of biscuits and 9 packets of chips? So you have biscuits, you have chips. So he has pulled out 3. All of them are chips. So you know chips has to be at least 3 out of 10. So you can have 3 chips, 7 biscuits, 4 chips, remaining biscuits, 5 chips, remaining biscuits, 6 chips, remaining biscuit, 7 chips, remaining 3 biscuits, 8 chips, 2 biscuits, 9 chips, 1 biscuits, 10 chips, 0 biscuits. What is the probability that the packet contains 9 packets of chips and 1 biscuit? Right. Now, this can be solved using conditional probability. We can also solve it using sampling, right? Let's see how to solve it using sampling. Okay. Now, he has picked out 3 packets and all of them turned out to be chips. If this was the case, the number of ways that he could accomplish, pick 3 packets out of 3. This will, if this was the actual distribution of biscuits and chips, it would be 4C3. If this was the distribution, this will be 5C3, this will be 6C3, this will be 7C3, 8C3, 9C3, 10C3. So this is your entire case of all possible scenarios. Your favorable case is this. Your answer will be this divided by sum of all this. Let's calculate this. 3C3 is 1, 4C3 is 4, 5C3 is 10. 6C3 will be 20. 7C3 is 35. 8C3 is 8, 7, 6, 56. 9C3 is 84. 10C3 is 120. So favorable cases is 84. All possible cases will be sum of all this. 5 plus 35 is 40. 40 plus 10, 50. 50 plus 20 is 70. Okay. 84 plus 56, 90. This is 140. 140 plus 70 is 210. 210 plus 120 is 330. This will be your case. Let's divide by 6. You will get 14 and 55. 14 out of 55, option C will be your correct choice. You can solve it using sampling, which is basically another way of solving using conditional probability. That finishes this one.